for the last bout of the boxing here at London 2012. I never thought I'd say it. We're about to find out who will follow in the footsteps of the great Lennox Lewis, Vladimir Klitschko, and Audley Harrison, all of whom are going to be watching this tonight to see who will be the next Olympic super heavyweight champion. Are you ready? The judges for the final bout of the men's Olympic super heavyweight 91 kilo plus competition are as follows. Number one, the United States of America. Number two, Brazil. Number three, the People's Republic of China. Number four, Kazakhstan. Number five, Cuba. And the referee is Vladislav Manishev from the Russian Federation. Now this final bout at London 2012 pits youth against experience, an Olympic champion from Beijing in 2008 against a world silver medalist from Baku in Azerbaijan. It's Italy against Great Britain. XL London for the final time. Are you ready?
Roberto Cammarelle. And in the blue corner, representing Great Britain, he won silver medal at last year's World Championships, Anthony Joshua. Round one.
The opening bell sound to determine the final gold medal in the Olympic boxing tournament. We're in the super heavyweight division and it is being contested between the man wearing red, representing Italy, boxing out of the southpaw stance, the reigning, defending Olympic super heavyweight champion, Italy's Roberto Cammarelle, against the man wearing blue, competing in just his first Olympic Games, the number two seed in the tournament, and reigning World Championship silver medalist, Anthony Joshua. This, a rematch from the World Championships in Baku, Azerbaijan last year. On that occasion, Anthony Joshua prevailed, securing what was at that point the most significant, one of the most significant victories in the history of British amateur boxing, en route to his World Championship server.
Style-wise, this could be perfect for Anthony Joshua. He's got to box at range, it's long range, keep that jab going out. It's very important that touch where he measures the distance. Gets a few points on the board and make this Italian come forward over his front foot. That means you'll come onto that right hand, and that's the tactic here. Mid, long range boxing, nothing else.
That victory Joshua earned over Cammarelle was at the quarterfinal stage of the World Championships in Baku, Azerbaijan last year. This, of course, the final bout of the Olympic boxing tournament, as it traditionally is, to determine the destination of the Olympic super heavyweight gold medal. Will it go to Great Britain, or will it go to Italy for the second Games in succession? Cammarelle says simply, as he gets through with a good left hand that followed the right hand. Joshua may have beaten on that occasion, but he won't beat me here. Anthony Joshua said for his part that he's concentrating on deepening his level of self-belief, deepening his confidence. His desire is unquestionable. How deep does that self-belief run through his competitive game against a man of this stature and this reputation on this grand stage? Good double right hand from Joshua. Snaps ahead sideways of Cammarelle.
There you go, you see. Perfect there. The way Cammarelle is coming forward over that front foot and walks onto the right hand. So that's what Anthony Joshua's got to do. He's got to throw more jabs though and just keep the movement going, because that's confusing Cammarelle. If Joshua holds his feet, that bring Cammarelle into it and make life a little bit easier. So keep the movement going, pop out the jabs, bring him onto that right hand left foot. There you go.
Anthony Joshua received advice to use that jab from none other than Lennox Lewis, the Olympic super heavyweight champion in Seoul 1988. As Anthony Joshua looking to fashion a clinch, he's getting clipped by some thunderous shots in the corner. Joshua trying to fight back, but he had been rocked solidly by a quick fire combination from the reigning Olympic champion Roberto Cammarelle. Caught again by the right hand out of that southpaw stance, and Joshua, his work became just a little bit ragged towards this final bell at the end of that first round. And perhaps that flurry of successful shots from Roberto Cammarelle was enough to give him a one-point advantage that he currently enjoys. He leads by 6 points to five over Joshua.
Come on, let's calm it down.
Yeah, well, I disagree with that. Joshua there just made a classic mistake of holding the feet. There was the two right hands. He was boxing perfectly up to this stage, then decided to hold his feet, got caught in the corner. He was seeing the double right hand again. Great from Joshua. But that last 20 seconds or so, got in the corner here, tries to take his man on now. Now he's in a danger zone. Mid-range work now from Cammarelle, because Joshua's holding his feet. That's brought the tag into it. And he's a helpful one, and I'm not going to disagree with that. So Joshua, that's clever, son, box long range.
Francesco Damiani waving that towel furiously. The silver medalist from the inaugural super heavyweight tournament in LA 1984, when he came up second best against Terrell Biggs. And here he's trying to inspire his man, wearing red, boxing out of the southpaw stance, representing Italy, Roberto Cammarelle, to an historic second Olympic title in the super heavyweight division. But the man wearing blue, boxing out of the orthodox stance, will have other ideas. Anthony Joshua, trailing by 1 point at the conclusion of the first round. He just switched off mentally as he got himself pinned in the corner and allowed Cammarelle to work away effectively with mid-range shots.
Simple boxing, he's blown that jab, there's the right hand, delivered at range, then he's out on the outside again. And he's just got to, as I say, keep that movement, circling his opponent. This is not allowing Cammarelle to set, you see, but the jab is the most important shot to measure the gap and then bring the right hand through.
Joshua 6'6", taking on Roberto Cammarelle, who stands at around 6'4". It's just the second time in the tournament, unbelievably, given his 6'6" stature, that Anthony Joshua had been the taller boxer in one of his contests. Prevailed against Eris Landis Savon in his opening bout by a score of 17 points to 16. Fluid movements of the Cuban really providing Joshua problems, and he takes a stiff right jab from Cammarelle and tries to work around the inside, didn't he? Second preliminary, in his second bout, he prevailed over the Olympic silver medalist Zhang Zhilei from China, 15 points to 11, and then faced a towering figure of the 6'9" Ivan Dichko from Kazakhstan, and won by a smart scoreline of 13 points to 11. Prior to that bout, the Olympic super heavyweight champ from 1988, Lennox Lewis, said, "Back this tall man up with your jab." Joshua took it on board beautifully and used that most basic of punches to terrific effect. He needs to use it more here.
Up the workout a little bit. The tempo at the moment is suiting Cammarelle. This fella's got slow feet, he prefers a slower pace. That's a little bit better. Anthony Joshua, more mid-long range work, and maybe he's got to double up the attacks a little bit more here. Joshua, a couple of straight jabs and then go again, but everything at long range. This is when he's got to go again, you see now.
His tempo is suiting Cammarelle down to the ground. 32 years of age during the course of this tournament, and he's continuing to have real success with that right hand in particular. Joshua's own right hand was long, and long left hook follow-up that came wasn't. Right on the target. referee just warning Joshua about illegal punches to the back of Roberto Cammarelle. Inside the final 30 seconds of the Olympic super heavyweight gold medal bout, Roberto Cammarelle looking for an historic second gold medal in succession in this heaviest weight class. Anthony Joshua looking to repeat the victory over Cammarelle that he had in the World Championships in Baku, Azerbaijan last year, but he finds himself with his back posted close to the corner once again. He was put under so much pressure during the course of the opening round. Good left hand gets through from Cammarelle, right hand response is on the button as well. And at the end of the second round, it is Cammarelle who leads Great Britain's Anthony Joshua by 13 points to 10 in this man's favour. And just look at the exhortations of his corner man, Francesco Damiani, a man who knows what it takes to stand on the medal rostrum, and he's intimating that he's just one round away from a second historic Olympic gold.
Joshua scored the right hand, a little bit puzzled by the score. It's good with the shot there. A little bit close. This maybe had Cammarelle just a point up going into this last round. Nevertheless, it's 3 points. Again, Anthony Joshua. Scoring better at long range. They're just switching off here and there towards the end of the round.
As if he's going to go back in 3 minutes.
Get hands down. Shot. Off the work rate.
Into the third and final round we go in this man's super heavyweight gold medal bout between the boxer wearing red, looking to defend his title successfully that he won in Beijing 4 years ago, Italy's Roberto Cammarelle, the 32-year-old Milanese policeman, and his opponent from Great Britain, wearing blue, Anthony Joshua, just 22 years of age, and this man has made a meteoric rise through the boxing ranks. Finds himself competing on the grandest stage of all, being cheered on by the crowd, but he finds himself trailing by 3 as we enter the third and final round of what is the biggest bout of his life, bar none.
I think he's got a target as well now as Cammarelle comes forward over his front foot. He may be the left foot and also the bolo shot, the right bolo shot into the midriff of Cammarelle. That's what he should be practicing and bringing him onto that shot, but finishing on the left foot. He's got up the work rate again. That's better.
Drives Cammarelle back towards the neutral corner on the far side of the ring from our commentary position. Cammarelle tries to waltz him back to centre ring. Referee allowing both boxers to work away. And of course, while no work is being done at close quarters, that will favour Cammarelle, who comes back with a crisp right jab of his own. Chopping right hand on the inside from Joshua. And now the two fighters engaging in a rather untidy exchange. And you suspect that this contest is becoming attritional as we approach a halfway mark of this third and final round. Good rally from Joshua, and again, rousing reception from the crowd, greets that work. More left-hand success from Joshua as we pass the halfway mark of this third round.
It's important that he adjusts his feet here, Anthony Joshua, because this man now, Cammarelle, is looking to hold on the inside. Got to adjust those feet, and then that'll give him the room and space to punch again. Come on, Josh, you can do this.
Right hand from Joshua just grazed past the chin of Cammarelle as we approach the final minute. And there are 3 Olympic super heavyweight champions in attendance here today at the XL Arena in London's Docklands. Super heavyweight king from 1988, Lennox Lewis, is here. The super heavyweight champion from Atlanta 96, Vladimir Klitschko, is here. And the champion from Sydney 2000, Audley Harrison, in attendance as well. That is who Anthony Joshua is trying to emulate. But he's trailing by 3 coming into this third and final round, and took a stiff left hand not too many moments ago. Joshua back onto the front foot. The boxers exchanging misses at the moment as we're inside the final 30 seconds.
He's got to work a little bit harder on the inside. This is really close now. I think Anthony Joshua's pulled it back, but needs a couple more. That's better.
Cammarelle appears to be feeling the pace. 32 years of age, he's had a hard tournament, and this is a spirited rally from Anthony Joshua. It brings about a response, as you would expect, from a great champion like Cammarelle. 2-time World Championship gold medalist, defending Olympic champion and gold medalist from Beijing 4 years ago. And as the closing bell sounds, Anthony Joshua raises his hands immediately because he feels he has done enough to overturn the man in the red corner, Roberto Cammarelle, and prevent him from successfully defending his title. But there is jubilation in the Italian corner because they feel that their man has just made history by successfully defending his super heavyweight gold medal after a really hard-fought FIFA heavyweight final.
Although he went into the round 3 points ahead, Anthony Joshua rallied here, found the target. I think he won the last round. It's if he won it by 3 points or more, but it was a better last round for Anthony Joshua. Double right hand there with a left and another right hand. He feels he's done enough at the end of it. Very, very close.
Very close indeed, but just look at the response in the Italian's corner. Francesco Damiani, practically dancing at the end of the round in recognition of the sterling work he feels his man produced. But Anthony Joshua raised his hands immediately as well. The outcome of this contest, the destination of the final gold medal of the Olympic boxing tournament, will be decided by the five judges seated ringside. Both men think they've done enough. Here's the official
verdict.
Ladies
and gentlemen, the judges scored it level at 18 points apiece.
We go to countback.
The winner on countback, an Olympic super heavyweight champion in the blue corner, representing Great Britain, Anthony Joshua.
Anthony Joshua is the Olympic super heavyweight champion. A wonderful achievement by this 22-year-old from Finchley, North London. He has overturned once again the defending super heavyweight champion. The second victory he has enjoyed over Roberto Cammarelle. And what it means is that on the grandest stage of all, this powerful young super heavyweight has just scaled the heights to be crowned the Olympic super heavyweight champion. Anthony Joshua joins a legion of legendary boxers down the years as Roberto Cammarelle exits the ring after a spirited performance. But Anthony Joshua, in securing a magnificent Olympic gold, joins a legion of magnificent fighters from down the years, luminaries such as Lennox Lewis, Roberto Balado from Cuba, Vladimir Klitschko from Atlanta 1996, and of course before the advent of the super heavyweight division in LA 84, the biggest boxers of all have been luminaries such as Teofilio Stevenson, Big George Foreman in Mexico 68, Smoking Joe Frazier in Tokyo 1964. Anthony Joshua has just joined their rank by claiming the Olympic super heavyweight title, and he received a handshake from the British boxer he has just emulated, Audley Harrison, who claimed this title in Sydney 12 years ago, shakes the hand of Anthony Joshua, and this moment belongs to Finchley's Anthony Joshua. A wonderful performance, a magnificent accomplishment, and Anthony Joshua will stand atop the Olympic podium in front of a home crowd here at the XL Arena in London, Scotland, to cap a simply magnificent game for Great Britain's boxing squad. Three Olympic titles for Great Britain's boxers. Nicola Adams, the historic winner of the first ever Olympic title in a women's tournament. Luke Campbell took bantamweight gold, and Anthony Joshua has taken the final gold medal on offer in the boxing tournament. And there is absolute jubilation in that blue corner. Disbelief, disappointment and despair in the Italian's corner, but high fives all around, because this young man has just completed the most meteoric rise in the course in amateur boxing. 4 years ago, he didn't even watch his fellow Londoner, James DeGale, win an Olympic title. He didn't know who he was. He didn't know anything about the sport. And then he followed his cousin, Ben Ayeni, down to the gym in Finchley, North London. His cousin said, come along, try this boxing. And the man who was a phenomenal all-round athlete turned his hand to the noble art. And within the space of just 4 years, he has scaled the heights to become the Olympic super heavyweight champion, the culmination of a most magnificent story. Anthony Joshua is the Olympic super heavyweight king.